Hello there, Ali here from Sports Templates, and today bringing you guys yet another template. I've received a lot of emails asking me for a fitted cap and a strapback cap, so I finally got around to finish these templates, and today I'm going to be working on these templates to recreate this new San Francisco Giants Players Weekend fitted hat. These caps just came out, and I thought it would be fun to recreate them, so let's get to it. This template includes three PSDs, so you get the front view, the back view of the strapback cap, and the back view of the fitted cap. In using the front view, I'll be creating the San Francisco Giants cap, and I already made a test before recording this tutorial, and this is the final look I'll be trying to achieve. I've already prepared a little Photoshop library just to make my life a little bit easier doing this. First thing, let's change the main hat color. So if you go to editable here, you have the base cap color. I'm gonna pick the orange, and usually the stitching is the same color, so we can go to the stitches and just pick the same color. That's it. I've also included segmented cap, so let's say you want to make you can just hide these for now. So let's say you want to make an alternating color, you can just do this, for example, and change these however you want, but for now we're just gonna do this Players Weekend hat. So just hide this, and then moving on to the brim, we're picking this off black color. For the bottom of the brim, I'm gonna do it also orange. Now what's left is the top button, also orange, and these little holes, orange as well. And I guess that's it for the hat, so we can now just move on to work on the logo. So for the logos, you have two options. You have the embroidered style, which are these. You have one for the side and one for the front of the hat. And if you hide these, you go into editable and you get the same thing, but if you want it to look like as if it's printed on the hat, not embroidered. So if you turn this layer on, you can see this one looks more like it's printed on the hat. The same goes for the side logo. So we're actually going to be using both of these to achieve this look, since you can see that the black part is embroidered and this gray part is really flat, almost as if it's printed this gray material here. So coming back, I'm going to hide these for now and hit embroidered patch front. So if I go and double click on your logo here, and let's bring in this San Francisco logo, make it a little big. I've already included these guides just to help you see where the center is. So let's center it here. Hide this one and save. All right, let's zoom in to see how we have this. Right away I can see that we have a little bit of this doesn't look realistic. These edges are too sharp. This is from the logo. The logo is supposed to have sharp edges, but when it's embroidered, these sharp edges tend to be a little bit smooth. So one trick we can do is go into the logo itself and control click on the thumbnail, which selects the logo layer, and if we go to select, modify, smooth, let's give it something like 15 pixels. Okay, so this smoothed out our selection. What we can do is right click, fill, and choose color, and pick the same color from the logo. Okay, this made the inner corners rounded. Now to make the outer corners like these rounded, just right click and select inverse. Just click backspace, and this is gonna get rid of these sharp edges. So control save, and let's see how we did. All right, now it's starting to look more embroidered. So if you wanna compare the two, here's before and here's after. It's really up to you and how you want your logo to be represented, but I think this is more realistic. So now to add this gray layer, we have to go to the add your center design here, this one inside of editable, and turn it on. Open this, and what we can do is, and now we have both logos opened at the same time. We have this embroidered smart object and we have the printed smart object. So to make them both line, we need to, this is the fastest way to do it, just go to this logo, keep pressing shift while you move it, and move it to the other document. This basically ensures that it's gonna go in this exact same position. So if you bring this back here, this is basically at the same position. So just to make sure we can compare it, I'll make this 50%, go back here, hide this logo, and just compare the two. It's exactly the same position. So now what I need to do is double click here, and let's pick a gray, almost off-white color. I think this is about it. Also, we need to add a stroke, make it on the outside, make it the same gray, and let's make it a little bit bigger. I think something like this. Click OK and Control S to save. Now it's fully centered, but the thing is, it looks a little bit off because in the embroidered patch we have this depth layer which is adding all this depth. If you remove it, it's gonna be perfectly centered. So to get around this, we can turn back the depth and then go back to the printed layer here. So what we need to do to fix that is we press shift and move it down a couple times, then shift, keep pressing shift, and move it to the left a couple times. Control S, and we get this. I think we can make the stroke a little bit bigger. So if you go back, increase the stroke a little bit. So let's try 20. Same. All right, that's more like it. Now moving on to the side logo. So we go add embroidered patch here, side, and we go to double click here. I'm gonna add the new era logo here. Remove this logo, Control S, and there it is. What's left now is just to edit the sticker. So if you go back here, you can go to the brim, inside of it you can add your sticker here. Add the new era logo again, copy the same color, and hide this one, Control S, and it's done. So I'm here. Let's zoom in just to give you an idea about the quality of this template. This is a 4K template, so if you zoom in, you can get really nice details. How all the stitches and the threads are going in, and it's fully editable. Now moving on to do the back view. So doing the same thing, going with the base color, picking the color, the brim, the same thing, the bottom part of the brim, get it orange, then the hat stitches, orange as well, the holes orange, and the bottom. Then going to add embroidered patch back, click here, double click, and add the MLB logo. push it down a little bit, remove this logo, and Control S to save. Alright, so if you zoom in, you can see that it's popping out just a little bit. And we can remove this logo for now because we already added the new era on the right side. And that's about it. So we just made the back and front of the new San Francisco Giants Players Weekend fitted hat. Thanks for watching and see you guys soon.